Good evening and welcome to Uppsala, Sweden for the eighth game of the 2014 Student University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. Nice warm evening this evening, warmer than we've had all week, Coach. And matchup for today is China versus Mexico.
Yes, looking forward to this evening. As you said, probably the best weather we've had, particularly since the first day, considering temperature, wind, rain, that kind of thing. Has rained earlier today, but looks good now. This will be the fourth game for China, their last game, and be Mexico's third game. See what they bring to the table tonight. I know Mexico would certainly be favored. And see what their starting lineup may produce in regards to starters, that kind of thing. Their big game is coming up Sunday with Japan. And
there's the standings after seven games played, with Japan in the lead with 196 in the plus, followed by Mexico with two wins and 115 points in the plus, followed by Sweden, three games played with minus 78, followed by Finland with three games played minus 90, and China bringing up the table with three games played and 142 in the minus. We're hoping to get a plus on that side tonight. We're hoping for it anyways.
They've been close a few times. Number 31, Zong, he's come close to breaking some long runs on some cutbacks and that kind of thing. Hopefully he can get loose tonight, as you said.
Then maybe ask the audience to rise for the hymn of FISU to introduce today's game.
On your screen, you'll see the Chinese defense. As we listen to the national anthems of both lands. Here is the Mexican lineup, defensive. As we get ready for the coin toss of the game,
the captains to get ready for the coin toss.
We'll bring you the names of the captains as soon as we see them line up. Chinese side, it is number 3, Yi Ben Wong. Number 9, Si Yu Shen. Number 82, Shang Zi Shi. And number 11, Xu Li. For the Mexican side, kind of hard to read their jerseys, but it's number 9, Fernando Rubalcaba Torres, number 92. Jonathan Colorado de la Peña, number 65. Nope, that's not a 65. That's a 69. Emmanuel Alonso Padilla, and number 88. Pedro Leonardo Mayanas Alanis.
Coach Chamberlain down giving his troops the last minute instructions how to start the game.
After the coin toss, looks to be as if China has won the toss. Bit of a problem with the microphone on the referee. China will receive, is a signal given on the field.
China team very exuberant before the opening kickoff, wanting to turn things around, get a good beginning. Hopefully that happens for them.
We wish them all the luck.
We don't wish anything negative for the team from Mexico, but China hadn't had quite as much success so far in the tournament as the team from Mexico.
They came close to scoring the other night there, Coach. They got it close to the goal line.
They got to the one-yard line, had a penalty, and took them back to the six, and they weren't able to get in.
I wish I knew what they were saying down there, Coach. have to ask somebody at halftime.
Imagine Coach CJ was right in the middle of it. He's pretty inspirational.
A mirror image of last night. The Swedish squad is in the bench in front of us, cheering on the Chinese that cheered them on last night. Back to return for the Chinese is number 34, Ni Duque, and number 31, Zhong Zhijiang, the MVP of the last game. Kicking duties are by number 9, Ruvalcaba. I do apologize for any mispronunciations of any names during this tournament. Ball taken at the 15-yard line by Shang. Straight up the middle, still on his feet. Gets a good gain out near the 30-yard line.
It's a good return.
15-yard return.
Good field position.
Kickoff goes to number 31, Zhong Zigan, who advances to the 29-yard line. Will China restart their offense?
Chinese quarterback, a quick pass out to avoid the sack.
Incomplete pass as the quarterback, Wan Yibing, gets pressure. Second down and 10.
Brings up second and 10 from the 29-yard line for the Chinese. Chong, the single back in the backfield. Quick pass out to number 88. Caught and on his feet. Still gets a plus gain of about 5 yards. They'll mark him down at 3.5. Ma Sheng on the reception.
Mexican secondary very quick to close on that play. Third and long. Double slot formation.
Third and seven for the Chinese. Back to throw. Draw play to Sheng. Still on his feet, cutting left and right. Close to the first down marker. See where they mark him. Good ruck going on there. They'll mark it as a first down. First down, China. Marked down at the 41-yard line. Good second effort there by the Chinese line.
Good run. Good continuation, not only by the ball carrier, but his interference as well.
Hand off to Sheng once again. They'll put him down to the half-yard loss.
Ball goes to number 31, Zhong Jigan again. This time for a loss of a yard.
Brings up second and 11 for the Chinese. Hand off to running back Knee around the left side, still on his feet. Puts his head down and takes a shot by the big linebacker, number 45. Marked down finally near the 44-yard line. Owen Ruiz Gomez on the tackle.
Chinese players were quick to get organized this year. They didn't have a lot of time to prepare and one thing or another, and that run just kind of showed that the ball carrier wasn't able to get his shoulders down. He pretty much absorbed the blow as well as, or instead of delivering it.
Another draw play to Knee out of the backfield. Brought down near the line of scrimmage.
Pretty well executed by the quarterback.
Might
no
be
place to run.
Gain of a couple of inches. Which brings out the punt team for China, who have been struggling a little bit from the long snapping position. High snap, taken, going backwards is the punter. Good punt, taken at the 30-yard line by number 7 of Mexico. Still on his feet, finally brought down at the 32. They'll mark him down at the 33.
Team Mexico may have them re-kick. I don't know that they will.
Jose Sanchez on the reception.
We had an illegal shift on the part of the left wing on the punt team in motion.
During the play, illegal formation, Team China, the penalty is declined.
The Mexican bench declines that penalty.
A great field position to start their first drive.
Brings up first and 10 from the 33-yard line of Mexico. Alejandro Garcia Blancas at quarterback. Hand off to the running back around the left side. Still on his feet in open field. Finally brought down at the 50-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 47. Lopez, the ball carrier.
An outside zone left. Got a good seal by the left tackle. Secured the edge.
Garcia's pass caught at the 40-yard line and advance for another 2 yards. We have a flag on the play at the line of scrimmage in the area of a hold.
They had their tight end covered up. He went downfield for the pass.
Illegal man downfield is a call. They'll be penalized 5 yards on that play. Repeat first down with first and 15 from the Mexico 48.
Trips to the wide side of the field.
Sanchez hands off to Lopez up the left side. Back to the original line of scrimmage, bring up second down and 10.
Run by number 3, Alberto Lopez. He's stopped by Yang Hao, number 52 in China. Picks up a gain of 5, second and 10.
Number 52, Hao Yang, the tackler on the play.
Similar formation with the back set weak this time.
Garcia looking to throw, going to his right side. Intercepted by number 24 of the Chinese defense. Huang Wei Chen on the interception.
Excellent break on the ball.
Looked like a shot out of the gun there, yeah. Coach.
Coaching staff is very excited for it.
The entire sideline is excited.
They well should be. If you were listening last night, you were able to hear the Chinese football team cheer on Team Sweden. They've formed some relationships, and tonight you hear Team Sweden cheering them on, turning the favor.
Quarterback out, throws through the hands of the receiver.
Got an open receiver on that quick hit.
Bonan Yuan, the intended receiver.
Incomplete. Second down and 10.
Quick screen.
Gets a gain of about 2 yards on the play. No markers, a 3 yard gain, bringing up third and 7.
For gain of 3, third down and 7.
The Chinese tempo is a lot faster than it has been in their previous games. Quarterback. Back to throw, throws through the hands of the intended receiver, almost intercepted.
Almost caught, almost intercepted.
Incomplete pass.
You on the intended receiver.
Interception by number 11, Abraham Omar Diaz. We have fourth down and 7.
Quarterback Hughes passing needs a little bit of work, but he's trying as hard as he can.
He's having to throw the ball before he gets his feet set, and that causes the pass to be fairly inaccurate.
Which brings out the punt team once again for China. Better snap this time to the kicker, number 82. Taken at the 25-yard line by Mexico by number 19.
Got to the outside.
Jose Manuel
all the way.
Still on his feet inside the 20. The 10, the 5, touchdown. Jose Manuel Barrios Ortega is the returner.
Don't see anything yellow on the floor except for some stripes, so I believe it's good.
No flags on the field. Here's a repeat of it there. Good blocking by the Mexican special teams. Getting out, leading their runner down the sideline.
No, I used to like my returners, and I'm sure a lot of other coaches do as well, make their, have your returner make the first man miss. He made the first two miss.
Snap is back, kick is up, through the uprights and good. 7 minutes remaining in the first quarter of play. Score is 7-0, Mexico over China.
We started out the game last night. No, it wasn't last night, it was the night before, excuse me, with two special team touchdowns right off the game. We've got one again tonight.
Fernando Ruvalcaba Torres wants a different ball. And he gets one. As he places it at 35, getting ready to kick off. Back to return is Shang for China, along with Ma Jihui. Good kick by Ruvalcaba. Looks like it'll go into the end zone. It will. And out.
Looks like it lit about 5 yards deep into the end zone. Good
kick. Be touchback. Chinese will start from the 20-yard line.
Touchback, and China will start at the 20-yard line.
That's one rule that's inconsistent with the American college football at this point in time. In America, they'd start at the 25.
Quarterback looking to throw out the outside. Bit of a bump on the receiver there. No flags coming. Receiver pats the defender on the back, saying, next time.
Most of the Swedish team, which we'd mentioned before, that's rooting for the Chinese team, felt that should have been a violation. I'm sure they're not exactly looking objectively at the game.
Quarterback once again to throw into the arms of the linebacker, number 58. Cesar Renato Balestra Echevarria. I hope I said that correctly.
You've had a challenging job, Will. Lots of foreign names. You've done a really good job throughout the tournament.
Hand off to Shang out of the backfield. Turns the corner on the left side and gets tackled immediately by the Mexican defense. That'll bring up fourth down. Fourth and 12 for the Chinese. They'll bring the punt team out once again.
The ball was out.
Referee's quick with a whistle there. High snap, taking it going backwards once again as the punter. Good punt. It'll drop and be caught at the 44. Advanced up the left side by the return man. Untouched into the end zone. Unless he stepped out of bounds, which I don't see anybody signaling. Nicholas
got that kick on the
run. Contlapara is the
right up the
return man.
Left sideline.
A credit with a touchdown.
Didn't have any contain out there. Was able to run it in. Fine return for team from Mexico. Well, we started off the game 2 games ago with 2 special team touchdowns. That's what we're doing tonight.
Kick is up and good through the uprights. It brings us to 14 with 5:57 remaining in the first quarter. Mexico leading China by 14-0. In game number 8 of the 2014 World University of American Football Championship. To paraphrase a great coach, John Madden, he once said, "You're only as good as your special teams." And that's the day that he drafted Ray Guy. Hall of Fame punter.
That was a good draft pick. And right on cue with what's going on in America with the draft coming up after a while. Second round.
Used to love watching NFL films. I probably could remember every one I've ever seen. Rubalcaba to kick once again from the 35 for Mexico.
I used to love to watch Ray Guy, but I didn't like the effect because I was a Kansas City Chiefs fan, and he had an ill effect on their performance a lot of times.
A low kick, it'll bounce, taken into the end zone, and through the back of the end zone. That'll bring us out the touchback once again. Well, you being a Chiefs fan, I'm a Broncos fan. You can think you up in that thin air what I was thinking.
He was a great punter. He got tremendous height on the ball.
I do believe they even accused him at one time during the 70s to have helium in the ball when he was in Denver. But he didn't need it. Sea level or up in altitude. Shang, the ball carrier, up the left side, hit in the backfield. Don't be marked for a loss of a yard. Still on his feet. That didn't bring him down. Got me looking the other direction there. Didn't blow, Coach.
I thought he was down, but maybe he wasn't.
That's his longest.
I don't believe he was.
That's his longest run of the game at a 7-yard gain.
Tacklers were on the floor.
That was a beautiful play by Shang.
He's very hard to bring down. He reverses his field. Don't know where he's going. Second time he's let go of the ball, though, so I believe he needs to do a little better job of hanging on to it.
Fake handoff. Quick screen out to number 9 for a first down. Beautifully executed play by the Chinese. Siyu Shen, the receiver.
Quarterback back in the game after coming out initial series because of an injury. Back in there. Nice job on the bootleg.
Looks like we have a flag on the play. They'll be called for ineligible man downfield. Like to see a replay of that play. I think he was right on the, I don't think the receiver was across the line of scrimmage. Very close to it.
Well, that was a setback, but hopefully they can recover here.
That'll bring up 2nd and 8 for China. Once again, back to throw is Chen. Down the middle of the field, intercepted by number 21. Still on his feet, returning up the right side. Nobody catching anybody's shirt. Finally brought down at the 15-yard line.
Interception by number 11, Abraham Omar Diaz.
Abraham Diaz Alarcón with the interception, which will bring up 1st and 10 from the 16-yard line for Mexico.
Free safety playing center field. Was able to catch side of the ball. Did a nice interception and return.
It's quite exciting to watch China open it up a little bit.
Yeah, I think the coaching staff feels they got to throw on first down to be able to consistently move the football, and I would certainly agree with them.
Like the fact that they're taking chances.
I realize that was only a second down, but they've been throwing on first down, which I think is certainly part of their game plan.
Looks to be a 5-yard penalty assessed against the Chinese. Are they remarking the chains is what they're doing? Okay, no penalty. Chains in the wrong spot of the ball. There we go, first and 10 from the 11. Garcia changing up his offensive line call a little bit there, looking at the throw. Garcia throws into the corner off the right side. Back judge Yelmerson calls him out of the end zone.
I don't know, I thought he had a foot down.
Looked like the back foot came down first there a little bit. Back foot on the line.
I think he had both of them down. I'm pretty sure his left foot was down.
Another angle here. I can't really see from there.
No,
good throw by Garcia.
There. But the officials certainly had a good look at it. So,
Magana's the receiver there. Hand off to Lopez up the right side. Takes a cut, walks untouched into the end zone. .433 remaining in the first quarter of play. Mexico leading 20-0 over China. Kick is up, looks wide right. No good, keeps the score at 20 with 4:33 remaining in the first quarter. As Rivacabo sets the ball at 35 once again to kick. Back to return is Na and Yuan. Boom and kick down the left side, taken by Na at the 5-yard line. Change the direction up the left side. Still on his feet, brought down near the 20. They'll mark him down at the 22-yard line.
Hard to run away from team from Mexico. Kickoff goes to number very good speed.
Excuse me, his name is not Na, it's Ni. Ni Duque. I formation, quarterback rolls his right. Intended receiver is number 29, threw over his head.
Tried another bootleg, but defensive end stayed home, was right there.
Incomplete pass. Ball intended for G. Payson.
defensive end may have got some coaching on the sideline after he let him outside that first time on the bootleg.
Chen hands off to
like team
the knee, but it looks like it'll be a turnover on downs. Missed handoff. Brings up first and 10 from the 17-yard line for Mexico.
Recovered by number 97, Mario Alejandro Soto, which brings in Mexico's...
Mario Soto Esquer is credited with the fumble recovery. Garcia hands off to Lopez straight up the middle, still gets about a yard on the play. They'll mark him down at a 2-yard gain. Placing the ball on the 15-yard line.
Linebacker made a nice play.
Garcia fakes a handoff to Lopez, rolls to his left, looking to throw, puts it into the corner of the end zone. Caught by the receiver, but out of bounds.
Incomplete pass, ball caught out of bounds.
Well executed play, except quarterback waited just probably one of his steps too long to throw the ball. Sometimes it's hard to wait on the receiver until he is open. You got to anticipate when he's going to come open and let it go then.
Especially when you're rolling to your left. Garcia looking to throw on the right side. Open receiver in the end zone, number 35. Gerardo Elizondo Gonzalez will be credited with the touchdown.
Garcia did a nice job of squaring up with that throw and coming to balance and throwing the football right on target.
Bit of a high step into the end zone there. I saw that referee Thomas Hjalmarsson gave him a bit of a reprimand because of that.
Usually the
field goal attempt is good, but we have a flag on the play.
Kick is up and good, and the flag is thrown on the play. Encroachment is a call. It'll be declined. That'll bring us to 27 for Mexico. Score is now 27-0 with 2:39 remaining in the quarter. The clock will roll the remainder of the game.
And I repeat, we have a mercy rule effective, meaning that the clock will run for the entire duration of the game.
I believe they need to back up just a tad bit, the returners. Last two been deep.
1 minute 50 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. Booming kick. Be taken by Shang at the goal line. Straight up the middle, full speed, still on his feet. finally brought down around the 25-yard line. Good return by the little MVP of the last game.
Fine runner.
Advances to the 24-yard line. First and 10, China.
Very engaging young man. Got an extremely nice personality.
Always got a smile on his face. One minute remaining in the game, or excuse me, in the quarter. Pitch back to Shang. Brought down for about an 8-yard loss.
Team Mexico playing very disciplined defense. Outside linebacker very quick to force that run.
Ball's marked on the 18-yard line. Hand off once again to Shang up the right side. Gets a gain of about 4 on the play.
Run by 31, Zhong Zhigan. And that's the end of the first quarter.
And that'll bring the end of the first quarter of play in game number 8 of the 2014 World University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. Score is 27-0. Mexico leading over China. After the side change, it'll be a 3rd and 13 for China. Shen throwing deep this time, intended for, caught by receiver number 9 near the 48-yard line.
Big tight end running the seam route down the field.
Shen CU on the reception. They'll mark him just short of the 50-yard line.
Coach Chamberlain called him right into the game before that play.
Chen CU is listed as a quarterback in our chart.
2 inches and they're into Team Mexico's territory.
Quarterback Chen looking to throw once again. Out to the open, well, number 34.
Wide open.
No. Knee Duquet on the reception. We do have a flag on the play. Conference by the officiating crew at the 50-yard line.
Play stands. That's good.
Good advance. Best field position of the day for the Chinese.
They got the running back out on a type of a wheel route behind their single receiver set.
Timeout called by the Chinese team.
Stop the clock on timeouts.
The clock should stop on a timeout. There you go. Finally stopped there.
That's the only time it does stop.
Cheerleaders are caught off guard there. Weren't ready for it. Impressive offense by the Chinese there, Coach.
Had a couple of really nice plays. Consecutive plays. Got the, as we said, the tight end loose down the middle of the field on a seam route. And got the running back out circling in behind the release of their wide out. I think that's the first time all tournament that they've had two plays consecutive plays for more than 10 yards apiece. Good
handoff to
good growth on their part.
Number 34. Ni Duque. They'll mark him at a gained yard. We have a second and nine situation for the Chinese. Handoff this time to Shang. He gets tackled almost immediately. He gets contact almost immediately. He's still on his feet. He's pushing hard. Gets a gain of about 3.5 on that play. Still digging.
I'd say that was on his own pretty much. He had a defensive tackle, get his arms around him pretty much at the line of scrimmage. A gain of 2 yards.
Official timeout. Discussing something with the coach on the Mexico sideline. Coach Chamberlain in talking to his boys on the side on this sideline. They'll charge Mexico with the timeout. After the discussion on the sideline. Chen looking to throw, but hands off to running back, number 34.
Gonna bring up fourth and short, about fourth and 2 yards.
Ni Duque, once again, a good run. Bringing up fourth and two for China. Let's go China!
Run again by number 31, Chomzhou. China keeps moving throughout this tournament. Shows a lot of power. He's got a couple of yards. We have fourth and two.
The sympathies for the Chinese team is certainly nothing meant towards negative towards the team from Mexico. It's just that team from China has had some struggles throughout the tournament, and people want to see them have a little bit of success.
China will be called with a delay of game.
Substitution infraction. Team China. Huddle with 12 men on the field. 5 yards.
China charged with breaking the huddle with 12 men. Substitute infraction. Be penalized 5 yards, bring up fourth and eight, 7.5, 8.
You're close.
We'll say seven. Fourth
say
and seven.
Seven.
Chen looking to throw. Quick pass out to Yuan. Gets the ball hit on his shoulder. Good impressive drive by the Chinese offense. That was a catchable ball.
Yes, it was. It was pretty well on target.
Defended well.
Well defended. Yeah. Cornerback did a nice job of breaking up on the ball to break it up.
Say something. Lopez around the right side, still on his feet. First down and more. Out of bounds near the 45-yard line.
Run by number 3, Alberto Lopez, for a gain of 15. First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Listen, great job, man. Rudy, you're going. You're going to go.
Quarterback Garcia looking to throw. Quick pass out to number 9. Still on his feet, running across the field. Still untouched into the end zone. Number 88, the receiver.
Number 88, Pedro Leonardo Magallanes.
Pedro Magallanes, the receiver, credited with the touchdown.
Excellent run after the catch.
55-yard reception and run. Ravakava's kick is up through the uprights and good. Brings us to 34 with 4:13 remaining in the half.
Good snap and hold. Sometimes we take those things for granted, and they're not always that easy to execute.
Ravakava places the ball at the 35 and is preparing to kick.
Hey, Mario, get your helmet. You can go in the game too, man. Hey, I don't have to. I'm going to be with you. Shoot a please. Get somebody.
Deep kick down the middle of the field, taken by Yuan at the goal line. Returns it up the left side, cuts back in into the middle and gets hit. They'll stop him at the 15. Ball will be marked on the 17-yard line.
Officials are used to waving the clock to stop, but since we're playing with a running clock, it has no effect.
Two minutes and 25 seconds remaining in the first half of play here in Uppsala, Sweden. Mexico versus China. Quarterback looking to throw out to the right side. In and out of the hands of the big receiver, number 88.
Pass, second down and 10.
We'll see if we can't get head coach of Mexico, Horacio Garcia Ponte, on the headset at halftime. Ask him a few questions. Chinese running back tries to take it around the right side. Meshang is stopped after a loss of two. Bring up third down. Bring up third and 12 for the Chinese from the 14-yard line. 1 minute of the game left, first half. Quarterback back to throw. Intercepted at the 26-yard line by Mexico.
Interception, Mexico. Ball caught by number 16, Fernando Chavarria.
Fernando Chavarria is the defender credited with the interception. 25 seconds remaining in the half. Mexico might get off one play here. Maybe two.
The official keeps holding them up. They're going to have a hard time getting off one.
Clock is running down with 4 seconds remaining. Official,
I think he's going to put some time back on the clock because I think
possibly put time on the clock, but the Chinese are already heading to the bench. That'll be the end of the half for the eighth game of 2014 World University American Football Championship here in Uppsala, Sweden. We'll see if we can't get the head coach of Mexico, Horacio Garcia Ponte, to take a few questions from us.
Don't forget to visit the Interpool restaurant tent at halftime to warm up and get some food and snacks and drinks. We have to stop that minute.
Well, what do you think, Coach?
Well, after having watched Team Mexico for two games, Team China for three games, I don't believe there's too many surprises at this point in the tournament. We knew that Team Mexico probably had far superior speed, have been playing a game much longer than the team from China, so we certainly expected them to do very well. Their special teams certainly had a big effect early in the game, getting them off to a 14-0 lead. I'll get it said in a minute. And it just kind of went from there. I don't believe there's any, as I said, developments that we weren't pretty well anticipating. I, you know, Team China made a couple first downs there consecutively. Had an unfortunate penalty that put them in a 4th and 7 rather than 4th and 2. Perhaps it took a running play out of the game. I don't know. But as we said, we'd like to see them have a little success, certainly not in stating, but certainly not wishing Team Mexico any ill effect. But I'd like to see the team from China have some success getting the end zone one time.
That would be a big morale booster for the entire squad. We'll shortly have Coach Garcia on the headset. Throw a couple of questions at him. Coach Garcia.
Hello.
Welcome to Sweden.
Thank you.
Are you enjoying your tournament?
Yes, it's a good tournament.
Any thoughts on the game today?
Yeah, the game of today, it's a good game. The China team, it's a play with a singular form. It's a good game. It's a good game.
Coach, do you feel that the rain earlier in the day has had any ill effect on the game and how it's played and anything like that?
Yes, in our team play, we need to play all the team, all the players. This is the idea from today.
You got two early touchdowns, the first two touchdowns from your kicking game, your special team units on the punt returns. I'm sure you're like most coaches, you emphasize your special teams and how important they are. How do you think they've done throughout the tournament, your special teams?
Yeah, we need to train the special teams from the game of the Sunday. It's very important. This game is the gold medal, definitely, but we need to train all the plays today.
Not to take your focus away from the game today, but what are your predictions for Sunday?
Yeah, it's very difficult, but we train from win. It's our idea.
Well, thank you, Coach. Good luck for the rest of the game and the rest of the tournament, and hope to be talking to you once again.
Okay.
Thank you. That was Coach Horacio Garcia Aponte from Mexico. We will take a short break here. They'll show you some highlights during the time that we're gone, but we're going to try and find a cup of coffee and warm our bodies up a little bit. Enjoy the highlights of the first half.
Punt goes to number 44. Touchdown Mexico. Number 3, the running back Alberto Lopez, makes his way. Okay.
Welcome back to Uppsala, Sweden for the 2014 World University of American Football Championships as China kicks off to Mexico to start the second half. Ball is bobbled by the Mexican return team. Gets a good return out to the 40-yard line. Almost a bit of a disaster for the Mexican team there.
Ball goes to number 44, Nicolas Cedric Compa, who advances to the 40-yard line, first and 10, Mexico.
Fernandez, quarterback, hands off to the running back up the middle. Gain of 9 yards. Lopez on the carry.
Young Hal picks up a gain of 9, second and 1.
Center. For you, those of you tuning in late into the game, the clock is rolling because of a mercy rule. It will roll nonstop, except for timeouts for the rest of the game. Fernandez looking to throw, throwing well short of his receiver.
Incomplete pass, third and 1.
Brings up third down and 1 yard. Fernandez looking to throw a swing pass out to his receiver. Still on his feet inside the Chinese territory. Finally brought down inside the 30-yard line.
Ball goes to number 7, Jose Mario Sanchez.
Sanchez the receiver, and good run after the catch for him.
Picks up about 26 yards. First and 10, Mexico.
First and 10 for Mexico from the 28-yard line of China. Fernandez hands off to Lopez in the backfield. A bit of a zone play up the left side. Missed tackles and into the end zone. Touchdown, Mexico. Brings us to 40-0 with 9 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Rawakaba back for the extra point kick. Kick is up and through the uprights. Good. Brings us to 41.
The extra point is
with
good.
8 minutes and 29 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
China or Mexico.
Bravo-Cava's kick is deep down the right side of the field. They'll let it bounce into the end zone.
Touchback. China will
touchback is called. The ball will be placed on the 20-yard line.
Okay.
Chinese offense is on the field. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. Wong in it, quarterback. Rolling to his right, looking to throw, complete. Out to number 9. Chen Siyu for reception. Completion of 3 yards. Brings up 2nd and 7 for China.
Gain of 3 yards, 2nd down and 7.
Wong under center, looking to throw once again. Draw play, hand off to Shang. Still on his feet, breaks out the right side. Gets up a gain of a, still moving forward when they blow him dead. Referee's a little bit too quick on the whistle there. He was still moving forward when they blew the play dead. Discussion with the referees on the field. It'll be marked down good enough for a first down. And they'll move the chains.
That was a run by number 31.
They're burning a lot of clock here, the referees are. The disadvantage of the Chinese.
Pick up 4 new downs. 1st and 10, China.
Once again, hand off to Shang. Still, or excuse me, number 34. Nidukai.
By Chong Shigang again. Takes up a gain of 6. 2nd down and 4.
Brings up 2nd and 4 situation for the Chinese. Wong looking to throw, puts the ball down the middle of the field. Up and grabs it is the receiver number 9 inside the 45-yard line of Mexico. Chen be credited with a 25-yard reception. Offense of China working flawlessly at this point. Wong looking to throw a quick pass out behind his receiver, almost intercepted.
Pass intended for number 87, Shanghai.
Number 26, Enrique Enriquez, breaking on the ball well.
Carter, did you think I left you?
No, not at all, Coach.
About missed the third quarter, didn't I?
Oh, you missed one heck of a run by Shang there. They blew him dead when he was still going forward. I couldn't understand that one. Wong hands off to Shang up the left side. Still on his feet. Out in the middle of the field. Looks like he lost the ball there. We'll see where what they call. I think he landed on the ball. See how the referees call this one. Looks like they'll call it a turnover.
Coaches from China are certainly pleading the case that he was down. That's a ruling.
They'll mark him down by contact. And it's very close to the first down marker, about a yard short.
Another great run by number 31, Zhong Zigang. Picks up 8 more yards, 3rd and 2.
Hand off to Shang in the backfield, brought down.
Inside linebacker brought a inside or an A-gap blitz and wasn't picked up.
6 yards.
Brings up a 4th and 6 for China.
Got back to the running back almost before the quarterback did.
Coach Chamberlain talking to his quarterback real quick. About to get a warning. Wong looking to throw once again. Quick pass out, blocked down, intercepted. No one to stop him, number 33. Good defensive play by Mexico.
Tremendous athletic play. Reached up, knocked the ball down, had the presence of mind to catch the ball. Avoided a potential tackler into the end zone for what? About 40? 50 yards, something like that.
About 55 yard run after the interception. Armando Chiavon Fernandez, accredited with the touchdown. Well, that's pretty much the way it's been going for the Chinese all tournament. Couple of exciting drives and then a turnover. Off the upright, but good is Ruvakava's
extra point is good.
Kick.
Mexico increases their lead to 48-0.
Brings the score to 48 at the end of the quarter. Mexico leads 48-0 over China, with the final quarter of play to begin shortly. Seeing some pretty good football coming out of the Chinese in their last game here.
They have put more good plays together tonight, I believe, than any other one single game. So I think, you know, that the coaching staff is gonna continue to talk to their team in the terms of progress. Not necessarily on the scoreboard or wins or that kind of thing, but first downs, yards made, stops made, those kind of things. That's all points of growing and progressing to become a better team. And they haven't had very much time to get together. And I'm sure in a few years, when they have an opportunity to work and play together and develop, they're going to look much, much different. Most of the other teams in this tournament have been playing American football for a long time. I don't know if people in America know that, but they have. Teams from Mexico, teams from Japan have been playing that for 70 years or so.
I got the information that the Japanese have been playing since around 1934. Rivacaba's kick is taken at the 5 yard line. It's bobbled at the 5 yard line. Yes, Yuan falls down on the ball.
Unfortunate. Hit his pad. I know we've had some rain today, and I'm not trying to coin a phrase after that, but the old expression, when it rains, it pours.
China will start their offense at the
seems to happen sometimes.
I tend to agree with you on that one, Coach.
Chinese, their backs against the goal line. Looking to throw a quick pass out to big number 88, who steps out of bounds at the 6 yard line, gain of a yard.
Ball goes to number 88, Ma Shen.
That play's worked two or three times tonight, to a little bit more of positive effect than that, but Team Mexico is quick to diagnose that.
Hand off to Shang up the left side, still on his feet, still digging. These referees are real fast with that whistle, and it's irritating me a little bit.
That was a well-blocked play there. I think sometimes on some of the other plays, he's pretty much made the yardage on his own, but that was a pretty decent hole there.
Bring up third and three.
Line. He was able to slide through a small space.
Third down and three.
Quick snap there. Didn't exactly see what happened.
Be interesting to watch a replay on that.
Number 29, the ball carrier.
For no gain, fourth and three.
Brings up fourth down from the 13-yard line. Punting from his own goal line. Ball take a bounce over the 50-yard line, where it'll be returned out of bounds at the 43.
Ball goes to number 19.
By number 19. Jose Manuel Barrios Ortega.
4 yard line from Mexico will start their offense. Quarterback
Fernandez hands off to Lopez in the backfield. Brought down for a loss. Good defense by the Chinese there. Mark him down to a yard loss.
2 yards on that play. Second down and 12.
Got some good penetration.
Brings up second and 12 for the Mexican offense. Fernandez looking to throw a quick pass out to number 82. Hit hard and brought down directly after the reception. Ulises Tovar, the receiver.
Pass to number 82, Ulises Virgilio Tovar.
Ticking down towards 7 minutes of time left in this final quarter of play of game number 8.
Third down and 6.
Fernandez looking for an option, pitches it out to Lopez. Still on his feet, open field. Arm tackle, gets him off balance. Finally brought down at the 9 yard line.
Ball goes number 3, Alberto Lopez.
That'll bring up first and goal for the Team Mexico.
He made an excellent cut up field. Should have been watching the replay, I wasn't.
Out of bounds at the 9 yard line.
Did a nice job.
For Mexico. Mexico.
Bit of an arm tackle slowed him down, get him off balance.
There's that cut.
Lopez, ball carrier, once again gets inside the 5 yard line. They'll mark him down at the 4. Brings up second and goal for Mexico.
5 yards. Second and goal.
5 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the final quarter of play. Game number 8, Mexico versus China. Fernandez looking to throw into the end zone, complete to number 86, or 88, excuse me. Pedro Leonardo Magalhães Alanis, credited with the touchdown.
Mexico, ball goes to number 88, Pedro Leonardo Magallanes, for a gain of 6.
Brings out the extra point team once again. Garcia holding. Rivalcaba's kick is up and good. Brings us to 55. With 4 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the final quarter of play. Game number 8 of the 2014 World University American Football Championships in Uppsala, Sweden. Score is 55-0, Mexico over China. China will get the ball one more time.
China's time is waning down to towards the end here in this tournament because this is their last game.
Deep
maybe
kick
their last
by
possession.
Rivalcaba. Bounce into the end zone. Touchback. Bring the ball up to the 20-yard line where the Chinese offense will take over. First and 10. Viewers of tomorrow's game, which is Sweden versus Finland. Kickoff time in Sweden is 4 o'clock at Österängen ZFP. Wong looking to throw, intercepted by number 20. He's brought down at the 50-yard line by Ewan. That'll bring the Mexican offense back on the field.
I believe if the quarterback had a little bit more arm strength, his receiver was about to come open.
Wasn't a poorly thrown ball, it was just a little short.
And Mexico will start their offense at the 49-yard line. 2 minutes to go.
Inside the 2 minute barrier for the final quarter. Mexico leading 55-0 over China. Fernandez out of the pistol, knees the ball. They'll let the clock run down.
Good sportsmanship by Team Mexico. It's easy not to try to pile on any more points.
Second and long.
Oh,
Well, the Chinese team, I believe, realized that this is probably the end of their tournament. But
great experience for these young kids.
It's been a pleasure to watch them play with their exuberance and their thrill to play the game. Never discouraged, no matter what the score was or what the outcome had been prior on any particular game. Very engaging young men.
As Fernandez needs the ball once again, with 48 seconds remaining on the clock.
Team Mexico is making preparations, I'm sure. Their coaches probably have been making preparations all along for their big game coming up Sunday with Japan to determine the winner of this particular national championship, not national, but world tournament.
As Fernandez knees the ball for the last time, the clock will tick down. The final score, Mexico 55, China 0.
And that will be the end of the game, ending with a score, wins in Mexico 55-0. And we'll give a extra warm hand to Team China for their participation in this first World University Championship. Very well-fought championship with a young team that's improved throughout the whole championship. Thanks a lot, China, for participating in this championship. Well played. Good job.
Final score of the game is 55-0. Mexico over China in game 8 of the 2014 World University of American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. Shortly we'll be bringing you the MVPs of the game. And then we'll be taking the camera into the media center for an interview of the coaches.
And normally the most valuable players from each team will associate with their company there.
Wouldn't be surprised if Shang gets it again. He had a great game.
And the MVP, the most valuable players of both teams have been selected. And the award in Team Mexico goes to number 3, Alberto Lopez.
Alberto Lopez, running back. Alberto Lopez Silva. Running back number 3 gets the Most Valuable Player Award.
Congratulated by his fellow teammates.
Our organizing president, Martin Sutherberg, running out with the trophies to the players.
Who is the guy handing out the prizes?
They rushed to it a little bit. They didn't give Martin a chance to get out on the field and set up.
Team China. The most valuable player of the game goes to number 9, Chen Siyu.
Give it to the big rookie receiver, Chen Siyu. Had a couple of great catches across the middle. And as you see on the camera there, he is exuberantly happy.
Chen Siyu had 53 yards and 3 catches on this game.
You gotta love to see that, coach. You gotta love to see that.
Longest yards was
29. It's obvious that it means a lot to him. Tears of joy.
We'll bring you some replays of the game here, but that'll bring the end of our broadcast for the day. And we wish you a good evening and want you to tune in and watch the final 2 games of the series of the tournament. Tomorrow it'll be Sweden versus Finland at 4:00 is the kickoff. And then on Sunday, it'll be a 4:00 kickoff with Team Mexico, who played today, and Japan. the two leading teams of the tournament.
Congratulations again to Team Mexico, and congratulations to China on a well-played championship.
And there's the table, and Japan leading with 196. Mexico not too far behind with 170. Sweden at minus 78, Finland at minus 90. China at minus 196. And that'll bring the end of our broadcast. We'll leave you with a recap film version of the game, a few highlights of the touchdowns. And for Mike Kersley, myself, Will Peterson, we thank you for tuning in. And we'll catch you on the net tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you.
Punt goes to number 44. Touchdown, Mexico. Number 3, the running back, Alberto Lopez, makes his way. Touchdown, Mexico. Touchdown, Mexico. Run by number 3, Alberto Lopez.